Hello friends, welcome to Free Grammar Lessons. In this video, we will learn 6 important rules of subject-verb agreement. So without a further go, let's get started. Firstly, we will remember what we already learned in our previous video. We learned the subject-verb agreement. So what is the subject-verb agreement? For a happy married life, a husband must agree with whatever the wife says, right? Obviously right, huh? In the same way, in case of subject-verb agreement, for making a sentence grammatically correct, a verb must agree with its subject in number. That is to say, in any sentence, singular subject must have singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. This is the most general rule, so I will repeat it again. Singular subject must have a singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. Please note, this statement holds true only when subject is in third person. Now, let me give you an example of it. Basketball rolls across the floor. Here, basketball is singular, so singular verb rolls is used. Let's look into an example where plural noun is used. Basketballs roll across the floor. Here, a noun is plural, so plural verb roll is used. This is the most general rule, and we have already discussed regarding this rule in our previous video related to subject-verb agreement. Please check that video if you haven't already or need a revision after this video. I will give you the link in the description. Now, apart from this general rule, there are some tricky cases. For those tricky cases, we have defined some rules. So now we will learn those rules. Let's start with rule number 1. Rule number 1 says, two singular subjects connected by AND require a plural verb. I will try to explain this rule with a simple diagram. Here, singular subject 1 is joined with singular subject 2 and it is joined by AND. So, it requires a plural verb. For example, gold and silver are a precious metal. Here, gold and silver are singular subjects, but combining them both makes the meaning of those words plural. So we used are, which is plural form. Let's look into one more example. He and I were playing. Here also, combining two singular subjects, he and I makes the combination plural. So we have used a plural verb were. But there are exceptions to this rule. If the nouns suggest one idea to the mind or refer to the same person or thing, the verb is singular. For example, bread and butter is his only food. Here, bread and butter is the combination which we consider as same only. That is one thing only. So we used easier. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Time and tide waits for no one. Here, we are using time and tide as a single unit for communicating the same idea. So we have used a singular verb waits. This is rule number 1. Two singular subjects connected by AND require a plural verb. Also, please remember the exceptional cases. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 2. Rule number 2 says, two or more singular subjects joined by or nor require a singular verb. Let's see this rule with a simple diagram. Here, singular subject 1 is joined by singular subject 2 and it is joined by or nor. So, it requires a singular verb. For example, neither food nor water was found there. Here, singular subject food and water is joined by nor. So, we use singular verb was. Let's look into the next example. Either the cat or mouse has been there. Here, singular subject cat and mouse is joined by or. So, we use the singular verb has. Let's look into a different scenario in this case. If one subject joined by or nor is plural, the verb is plural. And plural subject must be placed by the nearest verb. For example, neither the chairman nor the directors are present. Here, the word chairman is singular, but the word directors is plural. So, we use the plural verb are. Please also note plural subject directors is used just before the verb are. So this is rule number 2. Two or more singular subjects joined by or nor require a singular verb. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 3. Rule number 3 says, when the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the nearer. Let's see this rule with a simple diagram. Let's look into the examples to understand this rule. Neither you nor he is to be blamed. Here, subject you is in second person and subject he is in third person. But verb is nearer to subject he. So verb is used. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Either you or I am mistaken. Here the verb am is used as it is nearer to subject I, which is in first person. So this is rule number 3. When the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the nearer one. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 4. Rule number 4 says, words like either, neither, each, everyone, many must be followed by a singular verb. For example, every one of the boys loves to ride the car. Here, we have used a singular verb loves because the word everyone is used here. Let's look into one more example of this kind. Many a man has done so. Here, we have used a singular verb has because the word many is used. So this is rule number 4. Words like either, neither, each, everyone, many must be followed by a singular verb. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 5. Rule number 5 says, some nouns which is plural in form but singular in meaning takes a singular verb. For example, mathematics is the branch of study in every school. Here, the noun mathematics is in plural form, but it is singular in meaning. So we have used is here. Let's look into one more example of this kind. The news is true. Here, the noun news is in plural form, but it is singular in meaning. So we have used is here. So this is rule number 5. Noun which is plural in form but singular in meaning takes a singular verb. Let's look into the next rule. Rule number 6. Rule number 6 says, some noun which is singular in form but plural in meaning take a plural verb. For example, one dozen apple cost 1000 rupees. Here the word dozen is in singular form but it is plural in meaning. So we use the plural verb cost here. Let's look into one more example of this kind. The couple is going out this week. Here the word couple is in singular form but it is plural in meaning. So we use the verb are here. So this is rule number 6. Some noun which is singular in form but plural in meaning take a plural verb. These are 6 important subject verb agreement rules you must remember. Let's quickly revise what we learned in this video. Firstly, we understood the most basic and important principle of subject-verb agreement, which is in any sentence, singular subject must have a singular verb and plural subject must have plural verb. Then we saw the 6 important subject-verb agreement rules, which are rule number 1, two singular subjects connected by and require a plural verb. Rule number 2, two or more singular subjects joined by or nor require a singular verb. Rule number 3. When the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the nearer one. Rule number 4. Words like either, neither, each, everyone, many must be followed by a singular verb. Rule number 5. Some noun which is in plural form but singular in meaning takes a singular verb. Rule number 6. Some noun which is singular in form but plural in meaning takes a plural verb. So that's all in this video. I hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions or suggestions related to the lesson, please write in the comment section. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. Do share the video so others can learn and do subscribe to this channel and also press the bell icon to get regular updates about the course. We will meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye.